week of orientation, but he doesn't even know for sure if he has the job yet. Blake Barinholtz, candidate for Congress in Texas's 27th district, he's currently leading by nearly 800 votes against the Democratic incumbent, Solomon Ortiz. But there's still about 15,000 absentee ballots to be counted. Thank you for joining us today to talk about this close race and plans, if he makes it ultimately to Capitol Hill. Great to have you today.
Yeah, it's my pleasure to be here.
All right, give us the latest status on the update of your recount, I guess it is.
We've counted all but one county, and we've done election day votes there. All we've got is the Brownsville area, early voting, and mail-in ballots. There's only been a shift of about five votes there. I'm up by about 797 when we start, 792 now. So to find basically 800 ballots in just the early votes in Cameron County, you'd certainly have to raise your eyebrow. I think there's some shenanigans going on. So I'm actually feeling pretty confident for the first time. I'm no longer jumping every time my BlackBerry vibrates.
All right, so you have been here. Been in your orientation. What is it like to go through with this class? Not 100% sure yet you're going to be signed here and delivered to Capitol Hill.
Well, there are a handful of us who are going through it. We kind of commiserated a little bit together. So I had some, compadres and that. But the one upside to it I found is we had all this office draw. I went and sat and watched. I didn't get to participate in the office draw. And what the House Admin Committee tells me is I'm going to get the 27-year incumbent, first floor Rayburn office with a Capitol view.
That's a fantastic location. I entered many decades ago over in the Rayburn building, and that's a great location. So a test for you to not actually have to go through the lottery then.
Oh, it is, but I only get to keep the office for 2 years. They're going to make me move. Now, as a fiscal conservative, I might want to try to change that. Why spend a couple of $1,000 moving somebody out of an office they're perfectly happy with? But I'm not sure I'm going to have a lot of success on that, and not my highest legislative priority.
It is not, and you and I talked about during the course of one of your top priorities, because of your location has to be the border.
Right. Basically, my top priorities are jobs. I mean, that's the key to everything. But District 27 of Texas that I represent includes Brownsville and the border. And there's some real issues with the violence starting to spill over. We've got to work on intelligent ways to get operational control of the borders, and we're going to have to find a way to work with Mexico to deal with some of the internal problems. And we're going to have to work domestically to reduce the demand for drugs that keeps the price so high and puts all this violence, makes it all worthwhile for the gangs.
There are several key steps there, and a lot of agencies and people that are going to be involved with making that happen. Any concrete one or two steps that you want to start this process that would help?
Well, there really are a whole lot of ways, but we've got to take the simple common sense solutions to. We've got to kick up the enforcement of the drug laws and take care of the demand issues. And part of that, I think, is going to be jobs, too. As you get people back to work, you have less time to sit on the couch and smoke pot or do drugs. So if you're happy, healthy, and working, you don't have time to kill the drugs.
That's true. All right. Well, maybe the next time we see you, it'll be Congressman-elect or Congressman. We hope you'll come back and visit us.
Well, I'm claiming victory. You can call me Congressman-elect now. So I look forward to spending some time with you.
Sounds good. Have a great Thanksgiving.
Thank you. Same to you.